The tractor beam supports a uniform mass of 500 kilograms, and we're told that the center of mass is at G, and we got pins all over the place, two hydraulic cylinders, and that there's a second arm on the back side of the tractor, so that we're going to divide that weight by half and put that at G. The first thing to realize is that this is definitely a frames and machines problem. You've got all kinds of things going on here, and you're asked for the loads in the hydraulic cylinders and the forces in the pins at E and F. That means that you're going to have to dismember the structure to some extent or another. As with all other frames and machines, the challenge is to figure out exactly how. It never hurts to sort of start with a overall free body diagram of this whole thing. So we're going to include, for example, this whole bucket. That would be 500 kilograms times 9.81 gravity over 2, because there's a second arm. But the question becomes, what are the rest of this do I want to include? If I include the hydraulic cylinder at A and B, then I don't have to include part of it or the other of it. But there's no real point in including the hydraulic cylinder at CD. In addition, including this part right here, FD, that amounts to including two forces in a moment somewhere down here below point D. We don't know how this is attached. So really we want to make the part, FD, part of the world so that F becomes an external point. If F is external, then I know that it's a pin, so I'm going to have FY and FX acting at F. You can include the hydraulic cylinder and then make D an external point, or I can simply go ahead and make C an external point. A hydraulic cylinder is a two-force member, so I will have a single force here, CD, acting at some angle, theta. This angle, theta, is going to be given by the distances in your problem, which amount to 1.85 on the side and 0.4 on the bottom. Now, this free body diagram, where I have excluded CD and FD, amounts to having only three unknown forces, which is great. Three is my magic number. I can solve for that. So I get CD times the horizontal component, 0.4 over 1.8927, that's the Pythagorean theorem, equals Fx. And my Fy gives me 1/2 500 times 9.81 equals CD times the vertical component, which is 1.85 over 1.89527, and Fy. When I have to pick a place to take the moments about, I'm going to pick C, because then I don't have to figure out that angle. That gives me the weight acting at a distance of 2.1, Fy acting at a distance of 0.7, and Fx acting at a distance of 1.25. And the way I've got these drawn on here, all of those are in the same direction, so I'll have plus and plus. That's three equations and three unknowns, and you can solve. When I solved, I got CD was 16.3, Fx was 3.46, and Fy was negative 13.5. Now, that answers for me the hydraulic cylinder. Because I got this number was negative here, then I'm going to get CD is 16.3 kilonewtons in compression. I also can answer already the forces at F. The forces at F are given as 3.46 are found as 3.46 to the right and 13.5 kilonewtons down. Notice that I have to specify that this acts on the part ECF. Anytime you dismember a structure and you're looking at what the forces are on one part or the other, you need to specify whether or not this is right and down on ECF or right and down on FD. The other two things I'm asked for are the hydraulic cylinder AB and the other pin at E. The easiest way to do this is simply to look at the bucket by itself. If I take this apart, I have EX and EY acting at E, and another hydraulic cylinder, which gives me AB as a single force in that direction. This also has only three equations and three unknowns. So I have EX plus AB equals 0. These are even easier. EY is equal to the weight. And if I take the sum of the moments at E, I get the weight acting at a distance of 0.1 equals AB acting at a distance of 0.25, which you can solve. AB is 981 newtons to the right, and EX is 981 newtons to the left. The last thing I want to sort of talk about is why you can't just take the two pieces apart. It's a pretty common nature to consider just separating everything and considering the bucket first and then considering this piece ECF. So this is my piece ECF. If you do this, when you take it apart, you've got equal and opposite forces, EX and EY. These are determined in the direction by what we did at the bucket. And I will have still CD acting at an angle of theta. It's the same theta. I will have the same FX and FY that I had a minute ago. Be careful. If you consider ECF, you have to also consider that little spot that goes up to the AB hydraulic cylinder. If you take it apart at the base here, then you have to add two forces in a moment because that little pin is welded to ECF. But if I consider it all together, then I only have excluded the hydraulic cylinder, and I'm good at that point. This would work just fine if you knew what this distance was. But as it works out, you don't know what that distance is. It's not given in the problem. So while generally there are a lot of different ways to solve this one, problems like this, this one only really has this particular way of solving it. You need these two free body diagrams to get it done.